Welcome to Michigan for the running of the Pure Michigan 400. On the pole for today's race, Luke Rain, to the outside is James West. In third, we have Case B, and fourth is Stuart Grant, and Christian Merrick rounds out the top five. So your full season points leader coming into today is Michael Gregory. So he starts the race in ninth in that 31. And then your chase points leader is Adam Lewis. See, he starts a little bit farther back in the field. He's got some work to do to keep that chase point. So you can see he starts around the 30s. And you can see Jonathan Rains in the 29. He won at Michigan earlier this season in the Cobalt 400 in that Walmart-sponsored car. So we'll look to him to see if he can get the Michigan sweep here today. See, the front four are non-chasers. And you got your first chaser, Christian Merrick, starting in fifth. The pace car on the left-hand turn to pit road. We have 30 laps at Michigan to decide the winner of the Pure Michigan 400. And here they come down the front stretch. Luke Rain, James West on the front row. They will hit the restart zone. And the green flag is in the air. We're racing at Michigan. Here they come down the backstretch. See, no three wide yet. Now, Alex Stewart gets put in the middle right when I say that. And into 3 and 4, Luke Rain trying to hold the lead from Case Meehl. Samito gets to the inside. Can she get a run off the bottom? Looks like she will. It's going to be side by side to lead lap number one. Luke Rain in the outside. Case Meehl on the inside. At the stripe, Case Meehl leads lap number one of the event. And now this word's going to start getting dangerous here. When we start seeing three wide, that's when cars start bouncing off the wall. You see, they might go three wide for lead. Christian Merrick with a big run as they come down the backstretch. James West got the outside wall just a little bit. They're keeping it under control for now. Christian Merrick trying everything he can to get to second, trying to take that chase points lead. Coming through 3 and 4. So here comes Eli Bright in the 24. Jay Jefferson's going to split Luke Rainey. Rainey will go up top. Jay Jefferson will go to the middle. Eli Bright's down bottom. Casey Meadow still leading at Michigan, but they are three wide behind for third, and Christian Merrick gets to the inside, Samino possibly going into 1 and 2. And watch Luke Rain all the way up top. He hits that wall. That could be disastrous, especially with Michael Gregory right there. Rainey off the top, a little bit higher than Katie. Keeps it under control. Behind the huge spin. Jonathan Rains. Looks like John Gambit, Chris Dodd also involved. Two chasers. Oh my goodness. Here they are racing back. Christian Merrick will lead us back to the yellow. Jay Jefferson will get back in second. And a big, hard crash on the backstretch. Jonathan Rains has gone around. Same with Chris Dodd and John Gamet. Let's see what happened. Here they come racing down the backstretch. John Gamet all the way up against the wall. He's going to hit it. Come down to Chris Dodd. Jonathan Rains has nowhere to go but into his teammate Chris Dodd. And that's not what he would have wanted to do, I can assure you. And look at this hard hit for John Gambit. Oh! Hard head on to the inside wall. Same with Chris Dodd, but John Gannon was going a little bit faster. That's going to take that 16 car out of this race. And Jonathan Rains just spins down to the inside. It looks like he doesn't get damage from that. But let's go on board with all three of these drivers. All three of them have an onboard camera. And a scary accident for John Gannon on the backstretch. You saw that hard hit for Gambit there on board with the 33. Now it's going aboard Jonathan Rains looking for the Michigan sweep. Yeah, Rains just got put into the spin cycle there once he hit his teammate. And John Gambit, who probably took the biggest hit in this wreck, also has an onboard. Oh! That is one tough hit right there. Look at this from another angle and see if we can see what speed he was going once he hit the inside wall. So here they are. Ooh, I would wager about 145 possibly. Let's see, car slowing. And when he hits that wall, he's going 144 immediately down. Unbelievable hit. And then Chris Dodd, a hard hit as well. And that's going to take John Gambit out of this race. So Christian Merrick is back. They have stayed out. And the 47 car leads back to the green flag. He's one of your chasers right now up front. Going Brick Green here in the Pier Michigan 400, lap number 8, and tough break for John Gannett, one of your chase contenders. Out of this race, and he'll finish last among the chase drivers, so that'll be one chase point for him. As up front, we have Christian Merrick, in second is Jay Jefferson, third is Casey Field, fourth Luke Rainey, and Eli Bright, fifth Michael Gregory, another chaser, in sixth, seventh is Stuart Grattan, eighth we have Derek Bouchard, in ninth Jeff Bright, and tenth is Jack Marshall. 11th, we have Cole Luigi. 12th is Levi Shones. 13th, Jake Moss. 14th, Trey Rainey. Nathan Hood, 15th. In 16th, Tommy Turbo. 17th is Dan Bandon. 18th, Tyler Markle. Griffin Lynn. I don't know why I said Markle. In 19th, we have Anthony Wendler. And 20th is Josh Crash. Remember, he took that scary crash just a few days ago in the Arc Series race. Glad to see he's okay. They repaired the catch lines and everything. We're fine. 21st, Alex Stewart. 22nd, Jake West. 23rd, TJ Hanley. 24th is Keith Powell. And 25th, we have Adam Lewis. He's right now your chase points leader. In 26th, Jim Gamet. 27th, Rylus Berlitoo. 28th is Antavik Kingery. 29th, Evan Rudd. 30th, Blake Chappell. 31st is Larry Bouchard Jr. 32nd, Cynthia Bright. 33rd, Kevin Band. 34th, Tyler Lyman. 35th, John West. 36th, Jason Semino Jr. 37th is Jonathan Raines. 38th, James West. 39th, Alex Stewart. And Alex Stewart? It's Paul Minnick. Oh my gosh. And 40th is Chris Dodd. And they got 41st, Jonathan Buford on pit road. Problems for another chaser. He could go lap. He's gonna go lap down right here. He doesn't get going. He's gonna go lap down. I think he would be, even if he starts getting going. So tough break for Jonathan Buford, another one of your chasers. Three of them with issues here so far today. As the pace cars in Christian Merrick is out front. Buford still on pit road. So problems for the 15 team as they come down to the restart zone. The green flag's back. The we're back racing here in Michigan. See some drivers go up top, some down to the bottom. Bottom lane's going to be the place to be in 1 and 2. You can see Casey Mino pulling low for second. They go into 1 and 2. Look, wow, she went underneath the 47, too. 34's going to be going back to the race lead here at Michigan. Here comes Luke Ray, starting on pole, has a big run. Those guys got side by side in the 2-car, but Luke Ray has a huge run entering 3 and 4. Get the run for Luke Rainey right there. Gonna get to the inside of Semino possibly, but here comes Gregory. Three wide for the race lead down the front stretch. Casey Beal will lead at the line. Luke Ray tried to get a push from Eli Bright to get clear. Gregory, they're gonna be going three wide for the race lead in turn number one. Although the inside, not the place to be in turn one, like the way down inside. See if Gregory pushes up at all. Christian Merrick up the track. Jay Jefferson, four wide. Can't believe they did not wreck there. Michael Gregory, a chaser, trying to take second. Oh, there's a car blown up. Riley Sproulytube, another chaser. Oh my goodness, the chasers are falling apart here today. Has Buford still on pit road as well? Luke Rainey has taken the race. That's right now four chasers that have had a problem here at Michigan. And we're not even a third of the way through this race. With what they're showing, four chase drivers having problems. We're having a third of the way through the race. All 12 are going to have problems if this trend keeps up. As they come down the backstretch, Eli Bright is now side by side with Luke Rainey. These two missed the chase. They're looking to make their seasons better and get more wins. Michael Gregory, he has the full season points lead, and he's in the chase, so he's just looking for chase points and points. He's looking for everything right now. As he will get by for second. Jay Jefferson also missed the chase. He's coming for third. Cole Luigi there. Hasn't had a great season. Look at Jay Jefferson get underneath the 31 in 1 and 2. Threw right behind them, Jake Moss in the middle, Stuart Grattan all the way up top. They come down the backstretch. Ooh, someone popped the horn, they're going around, it's Levi Shones! Gets at Tevin Kingery, gets the 83, and spinning in front of the pack, the yellow will come out. Here comes Michael Gregory underneath Eli Bright for the race lead. Shones goes around, collects many others in the back. And coming to the caution flag, see Michael Gregory. I'm going to make sure Tommy Turbo did not. Okay. He was way up high. I thought he was going to bounce off the wall and into some drivers. So Michael Gregory leads us back from problems for Levi Shones, Nathan Hood, and others. Shones is way up against the wall right here, and he's going to come down off of it into Jake West, then bounce right up back and spins out. And Tevin Kingery, trying to avoid it, hits him hard. Nathan Hood hits hard. Up into the outside wall. Jim Gambit. Problems for the Gambits here today. Adam Lewis misses it. Look at these guys. Avoiding it. Wow. That is insane how they were able to. Oof. Wendler and Chris Dodd made some contact there. Trying to avoid Jim Gambit. All right, so back to the line. First, Michael Gregory in the 31. Getting some points. He actually won at Richmond, just furious going. They're coming on pit road. They're thinking they can make it. And tough break for Alex Brigley, but Piston on that 22 car has him out of the race. However, if Jonathan Buford can't improve his position at all, Spurley Tube will still be able to get 10th in the chase and not 11th, so that could be beneficial for him getting an extra point. I don't think anyone has stayed out either. It looks like everyone is coming down pit road. So let's see what happens. Who gets out in front? What does Gregory take, first of all? Four tires, two tires, no tires? No tires for Gregory. No tires for Reliver leaders. Jay Jefferson will take at least two. Some gambling going on here. Eli Bright takes none. Stuart Grant takes none. Jefferson taking two. Does that work for him? Does two tires work? Casey Mina is also taking two. Casey Mina will be taking four. So Jay Jefferson will be the first off with two tires. Michael Gregory will be your first off hero with no tires. Interesting to see what works here at Michigan. And here we go. We'll be going back green at the halfway mark, lap number 16. No cars retired from that wreck. We still have 38 on the lead lap with Michael Gregory out front. In second, we have Luke Rainey. Third, Stuart Grant. Fourth, Eli Bright. And Koluigi, fifth. Jake Moss in sixth. Seventh, Trey Rainey. Eighth, Dan Bannon. In ninth, we have Adam Lewis. And tenth is Jay Jefferson. He's on two tires, remember. Jeff Bryan, 11th. 12th, Tommy Turbo. 13th is Alex Stewart. 14th is Griffin Lynn. And 15th, we have Jack Marshall. And 16th, we have Derek Bouchard. 17th is TJ Hanley. 18th, Jason Smeal Jr. 19th, Jonathan Raines. After that spin, he's coming up to the front. And James Weston, 20th. Blake Chappell, 21st. 22nd, Keith Powell. 23rd, Cynthia Bright. 24th, Jake West. 25th, John West. Ty Lemon, 26th. 27th, Paul Mayer. 28th, Kevin Bannon. 29th, Chris Dodd. And 30th, we have Evan Rudd. 31st, Larry Bouchard Jr. 32nd, Josh Crash. 33rd, Christian Merrick. 34th, Levi Shones. 35th, Case Meal. 36th, is Jim Gamet. 37th, Nathan Hood. 38th, Anthony Wendler. 39th, and Tevi Kingery. So we had some four tire stops on that too. Christian Merrick is all the way at the back. Same with Case Meal. They took four, so it'll be interesting to see how they are able to work that out. So the front nine take two, no tires. Jay Jefferson takes two. He's going to be 10th. Last time we were at Michigan, which was earlier this season, the Cobalt 400, we had some drivers take no tires and then some took two. Tommy Turbo was out front. He came and took two. He ended up passing some cars, getting up to the top five spot, but he could not take the lead. See if Jay Jefferson, his teammate, can do something similar to that here today, except Jay Jefferson wants to take that lead. He wants to be gone. He wants to win at Michigan. There we go. Pace car into pit road. Restart halfway. 15 laps to go when we get the green flag. Michael Gregory out front. And Tevi Kingery, who is inside the damaged car. Luke Rainey right behind Gregory as they come down the front stretch. The green flag is back there. We're back racing here at Michigan. Watch the inside. Not going to be going. That's Tevi Kingery. In the 87. Jeff Bright might be the first to get trapped unless he can get up to the high side. Jeff Bright trapped down low. The outside's going to be the place to go. Now the inside, the middle, not going to be going. Tommy Turbo's going to be the one that's getting blocked the worst. Down the backstretch they come. The bell for the lead. Luke Rainey has gotten past Michael Gregory with a big push from Stuart Grant down the backstretch. Some scrambling back there trying to block. Get down low. Into 3 and 4 they come. Battling hard up front. Luke Rainey has gotten clear. Stuart Grant, Koluigi up to third. 42 team has not had a great season. After leading Dodd to an almost championship last season, they're looking for a better one or a better race here today, possibly even a win. Here comes Stuart Grattan. 98 Red Bull Ford. Can he grab it? He's going to clear Luke Rainey off turn two here. Watch Gregory all up against the wall. Eli Bright also hits the wall. Ooh, Lyman into the wall pretty hard. Koluigi, big run. 42 car has something for him, doesn't he? Coming to 13 laps to go. Koluigi will lead here at Michigan. 42 target Chevrolet for Chip Ganassi. Leads at the stripe. He has Jake Moss, though, coming hard behind the 32 car, the Ford. Luke Rainey, Trey Rainey, fourth and fifth. The Raineys could work together. They get up front, get positions. Trey Rainey needs to beat some other chasers. Right now, he's just doing what he needs to do. He doesn't even have to win. Look at how close they are up front here. Three wide for the race lead. Koluigi goes all the way up top. Grant went to the middle. Jake Moss went all the way to the bottom. at the stripe. I think Stuart Grant might have led. He did, but barely. That was a dead tie, dead heat at the line. Trey Rainey to the bottom. He got tight, though. He had to let off the gas. Here comes Alex Stewart. Stuart Grant hits the wall hard. So is Cole Luigi. They're scrambling, trying to get by. Trey Rainey will get by Alex Stewart in the 27. Here comes Dan Bandon. He almost won this race earlier this season. He gets tight all the way down the bottom. TJ Hanley trying to go around the outside. Jeff Bright's on the outside. Yeah, Dan Bandon got really tight down low. He got really down low. Jake Moss has pulled away. Here's a battle side by side. Adam Lewis has Cole Luigi behind him. Luke Rainey up top. Stuart Grattan up top. Cole Luigi to the bottom. Gets tight. Alex Stewart looking. Stuart Grattan pops the outside wall again. Dan Bandon's in the outside wall. Alex Stewart side by side for a second as they come down the back with Trey Rainey. Come to 10 laps to go. Here they come. Alex Stewart will take second for Trey Rainey. 10 laps of racing to go this time. Man, oh man. It's getting exciting here. Trey Rainey down the outside. He has a teammate who is also in the chase. And Lewis is leading the chase points as of now. Another great run for him here today at Michigan. As they come down the backstretch, if he can hold it there, he will definitely keep that chase points lead. But they are side by side, door handle to door handle as they hit 3 and 4 for the race lead. Alex Stewart on the bottom. Jake Moss up top. Stewart will clear. He drives up. Here comes Luke Rainey with Adam Lewis pushing him. Three wide. Jay Jefferson has put two CGR teammates up top. Jefferson wants to win badly. You know, Cole Luigi up there wants to win badly. Griffin Lynn, anyone who's not in the chase, they definitely want to win badly. Luke Rainey really loose in the center of 1 and 2. Allows two cars to get by. Jake Moss and Alex Stewart both gotten by. Luke Rainey gets settled back into third. Adam Lewis is side by side with his teammate Trey Rainey. Adam Lewis really... Is he coming down pit road? Oh my goodness, Adam Lewis, Jason Smale Jr., and Jonathan Raines are coming down pit road. Do they have enough fuel? Does everyone have enough fuel? 8 laps to go. Jake Moss and Alex Stewart side by side have the guy... If they took fuel only on, are they going to be good on fuel? I think they should be. Is anyone else besides those guys? Tyre Lyman has also come down pit road. Interesting. Jake Moss, Alex Stewart side by side. Luke Rainey has joined this battle. I think it might just be those few that came down pit road. Very interesting there. So it's kind of settled down the racing up front. We right now, watch Levi Shones though. Watch Shones. They're going to the outside. They're going to split him in the middle. They are. Luke Rainey going to the bottom lane. Jay Jefferson might get caught. Whoa, to the high side. Close there for Jefferson. Look at Alex Stewart with the run on Jake Moss. Moss pops the outside wall. Few are. Trey Reynolds gets spun by Griffin Lynn. He might have been trying to block him as well. Shones holding up the pack. Behind. Right now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 cars in this pack. Coming to the stripe. 6 laps to go this time. Alex Stewart leads the way. Luke Rainey, Trey Rainey going to try and run him down. 3 wide for 5th. TJ Hanley out of nowhere. He started back in like the 30s, I think. Here he is in a top 5 spot with 6 laps to go. Can Alex Stewart hold on? Can Luke Rainey get the win? Can Trey Rainey get the win? Can Griffin Lynn get the win? Watch it, Tevin Kingery head very slow. They go to the outside. The front few will. Front four to the outside. TJ Hanley will also stay up top. Jay Jefferson and Jake Moss are balanced side by side. This could really hurt Moss. Unless Kingery slides up, which he will. But Jay Jefferson has room on the outside. Luke Rainey got very slow. He might have hit the wall. Alex Stewart has a big lead with 5 laps to go. And Griffin Lynn's gotten to second. And TJ Hanley has pushed him to... Pushed way up to third. He's going for the second. Is that all she wrote for anyone behind Alex Stewart? Right now, Stewart has a pretty big lead. If the caution comes out, the race is over, remember, as they're hitting the wall back there. And that's why I mentioned if the caution comes out, the race is over. TJ Hanley side by side with Griffin Lynn. They're going to have to clear and form a line to catch Alex Stewart. They have to get in his draft to catch him. Let's see what the gap is to the line with 4 laps to go. Man, almost 9 tenths. If they could form a line, though, they will catch Alex Stewart as long as the caution doesn't come out. The draft's so big here at Michigan. It's just like California and Pocono and Indianapolis. The draft can propel everyone back together. We're going to keep this up here just to show you if the gap closes at all. And TJ's coming with Griffin Lanau. Even if they get side by side, I think it would be fine. Tanley way tight up the track. He's really up high, man. And they're side by side. 3 laps of racing to go at Michigan. The gap has definitely closed. It's down to half a second. Some of the other pack is starting to close in. TJ gives Griffin enough room down bottom, but they are keeping pretty equal as they come down the back stretch. Yeah, they're still side by side equal because they're both getting the draft of Alex Stewart. Jonathan Raines is ahead, but not slow. Whoa, Alex Stewart's coming down pit road! Trey Rainey's coming down pit road! Who else has come down? Is that Cynthia Bright Lampshire Jr.? And now it's a side-by-side battle. Griffin Lane, TJ Hanley has taken the race lead. 2 laps of racing to go. And while we're focusing on these two, don't forget Jay Jefferson, the 48, back there in third. Luke Rainey's in fourth. Jack Marshall's up to fifth. Where's Keith Powell come from up there in the top 10? Griffin Lynn's pitting. TJ Hanley's all by himself. And Jay Jefferson's up to second. Fuel strategy at Michigan. The white flag is out for TJ Hanley. Can he make it 1 more lap? 2 miles. Can Jay Jefferson close in? Do they have enough fuel to get back around and finish it? Griffin Lynn running second, trying to run down TJ Hanley pits. The lap before your race leader came up here at Alex Stewart. Are these guys able to stay out? Half a lap to go. They're side by side. Here comes Jack Marshall and Jay Jefferson. Into 3 and 4. TJ Hanley has been around for 4 seasons in the Gatorade Cup Series. The drought is finally over as he comes off of turn number 4. TJ Hanley's a winner in the Gatorade Cup Series. Jack Marshall gets to second, Jay Jefferson third. The pit strategy comes up late, but the 30 Swan Racing team of TJ Hanley. Hanley, his first career victory at Michigan. Fuel mileage, he's in the chase, and how this will propel him in the chase. Many chase drivers had problems, many pitted. Wow, what a wild Michigan race, and that's what we like to see in the Gatorade Cup Series. Wildness. Unpredictability. Who would have predicted that TJ Hanley would have won this race? All right, now let's go to the finishing results. Here are the finishing results from the Pure Michigan 400. At Michigan, there were 2 caution flags for 8 laps and 13 lead changes among 10 different drivers. TJ Hanley finally gets that well-deserved Gatorade Cup Series victory. He's been around since the first race of season 1, and it's honestly been surprising he hasn't won. Chaser, he finishes first among the chasers. He led 3 laps. I don't even remember him leading 3. In second, it was Jack Marshall. Jay Jefferson, close again, but he ends up third. Another great run for that 48 team. Jake Moss, fourth. And Luke Rainey, starting on Poland's up fifth. Cole Luigi, another great run for people who haven't been in the chase. Great runs for them. He ends up sixth. Kevin Band in seventh. He's another chaser. Case Mito, eighth. Ninth, James West. And in tenth, we have Jake West. So there's your top 20. See, in the top 20, personally, no one led the most laps in the top 20. Just shows how much Michigan is a wild card. Doesn't even matter where you start. We had Luke Rainey start on pole. He finishes 5th. TJ Hanley won the race. He started 31st. Jake West started 29th. He ended up 10th. Does not matter where you start. It matters where you finish. And Michigan is one of those places where you can gain a lot of track position. Alex Stewart, that has to be heartbreaking for that 27 team, was leading with only a few laps to go. And he has to pit for fuel. He ends up 26th. He led the most laps of 6. And some chasers having some problems down towards the bottom. And with this, Chris Dye's taken over the chase points. We'll actually show you them in a minute. And he has a pretty big tie behind him. Now look at the point standings. Here are the point standings after Michigan. You can see it's Michael Gregory still with the points lead, 123 points over Kevin Bannon, who is now second. Anthony Wendler third, John Gamet fourth, and Josh Crash fifth. Adam Lewis in 6th, Chris Dye 7th, 8th, TJ Hanley after that win. In 9th, we have Trey Rainey and Christian Merrick 10th. So there's your top 20. Pretty wild Michigan race. And at this point, I'm probably showing you the chasers. And right now, Chris Dodd has 18 points and he's leading by 1 point over 4 drivers who are tied for 2nd in the chase points. That's insane that we got 4 drivers tied. Even after 2 races, it's pretty insane. But that'll start to get even you know, kind of spread out. We'll finally start seeing who really is the best out of them. Although last season we had 11 of 12 drivers that could win the championship at Homestead, which was pretty wild. All right, so the next race also could be another wild one. It's the Pennsylvania 400 Pocono. See you guys then.